Power BI June 2018 update. Only what you need to know in 5 minutes or so. Let's get started. So we're going to cover the highlights first. But sometimes, my friends, the biggest highlight is what's not there, what's missing. I'm going to save it for the last, so make sure you keep watching till the end of the video. Now, if this is your first time on the channel, then make sure you click subscribe and click the bell icon so you're notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. So let's start with number one, filtering and sorting in data view. Now, this is something which has always been available in Excel Power Pivot, which is a cousin of Power BI. Right, but now this comes to Power BI. So in Power BI desktop, in the data view, you can filter, you can sort. Now this is a convenience feature, and as you're working with data, sometimes you're checking on this, do I have this data, you're trying to debug a measure, and this makes it very convenient to kind of figure this thing out. Now you do have different options for specific options for text filters, number filters, and date filters, but I want to make sure that you realize the distinction between this in the data view versus this in the query editor. So again, in the data view, it doesn't really make any impact. It's just for your convenience. It's just for you to check something out really quick. It doesn't impact what the data is stored in the model or what's being shown in the reports. On the query editor instead, that filters the data out from the source. So it's not loaded into the model and it's not going to be available to be shown in any of the reports. Now, I hope that makes sense. I know there's going to be that one person out there who's going to say, oh gosh, I'm filtering my data and it's not working. Well, if you get stuck there, leave a comment there. All right, number two, custom visual organization chart. Now, normally I don't talk about custom visuals because I'm totally a Stephen Few fan, and he's all about less is more, economy of pixel and all that. Really simple elements when combined with thought, with planning, column charts, line charts, bar charts, tables, can create the best of dashboards. So usually I stay away from custom visuals because they are very whiz-bangy, but I think this is a very cool visual organization chart. So if you have this need, it's going to be very useful. Now, I of course have a very specific scenario where I want to use this. Now, I love measures, and often my production models end up with hundreds and hundreds of measures. I also have a very specific style of building measures. I think of them as Lego blocks. So I define really simple measures and then combine them to create more complex measures. And for me, I want to plot them on an org chart, see which measures are dependent on that. Anyway, we'll see how that turns out. Number three, a longer phone layout. Now, this was pretty much a reminder for me that this feature is available. Now, if you are using a phone, which you shouldn't, Power BI is on mobile phone, dashboards look beautiful pretty much no matter what. So they're responsive, they lay out automatically, they look great. Reports, not always. So if you are in the landscape mode, then the report, you're going to see it just the way it shows up on your desktop. And yeah, sometimes it looks small. But you do have control. If the phone goes in portrait mode, you can totally control exactly how it's laid out and make it a little more suitable to the phone. And now you just have a little more screen real estate and allows you to scroll to build that. Number four, donut radius control. Again, Stephen Few fans, and not a huge fan of pie charts or donut charts. They're not the most effective and efficient way of communicating data. But if you are using that, now you have a little more control over that and how you display that. You also have more control about how you position the labels and such. I also wanted to mention some of the other features. Now, Power BI has made it clear that accessibility is one of their main focuses, and in June update, they released one of the key features around that, around high contrast support for reports. Also, a bunch of stuff going on in data connectivity. If you're using any of these connections, then, well, you're in luck. Now, you can click here to watch the complete update video from Microsoft, but my friends, I said there's something missing, right? And that's the biggest news here. What's missing is the meat. I mean, not to take anything away from all the work that's been done in the June update, but there's no eye-popping features. There's no big news here. And guys, this is the calm before the storm. So Microsoft Power BI Summit, yeah, that's what I call it, is just around the corner, July 22nd and 24th. And they've had really big announcements around that, and they've shown something really cool. So I think the team is saving up for that, and I literally cannot wait. This is going to be amazing. Now, hey, so of course, I would like to invite you officially to the Power BI Summit, and you do have a chance to catch me there, not in one, two, three sessions, actually. So I'm going to be presenting with the one and only Matt Allington. the prep and model your data in Microsoft Power BI. It's a full day workshop, pre-day workshop, and we're also doing a 3-hour workshop version of that. And then I also have a regular session, 60 minutes, top 10 Power BI rookie mistakes to avoid. So come see me at the Power BI Summit. And we're also going to have an official meetup. If you are in the Learn Power BI family, if you're a student in my program, we're going to have an official meetup and send out communication on that. But it doesn't matter where you are. Hey, if you love me, come see me. Give me a hug. All right, my friend, power on. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.